Hi everyone, this is Chicho. Welcome to my channel. Now, right now, we're sitting at the end of February. I think like February 21st or something like this. And from a previous video, you probably know that I'm on a sort of a Bill Hicks break right now, right? But I'm sort of shooting this video because I ended up getting a couple of packages, comic book buys, that I do need to crack open so I can leave feedback for the sellers on eBay. And I figure I shoot the video. And if you recall, in a previous, probably a couple of previous comic book haul videos, I mentioned that for me, the time that I end up doing certain buys on eBay, certain reading buys and collecting buys and stuff on eBay, I try to do them in January and February because that's a good time to buy things. A lot of things people are totally tapped out because of the holidays, I guess. So things go at a fairly good price online and in stores as well. Okay, so I ended up buying these two comic book lots, I guess, and they're from different buyers, unfortunately, so I had to pay shipping from both buys. Okay, and what I want to do is show you one of them first right now, and then we'll take a look at the other one. And basically, if you've seen some of my other videos, you'll know that I'm a Brian Azzarello fan. Right, I love his writings, and I think he's an amazing storyteller. So what I ended up buying is a Wonder Woman in New 52, and I bought almost the full set. I believe it includes the full set of the Brian Azzarello. I think so. Another writer came on towards the end. So basically, I ended up buying the full, 40 issues, 42 issues of New 52 Wonder Woman. So I want to crack this open, and I've bought from this seller before, okay, so, and I've never had any problems with the seller. One of the comics I had a minor issue with that I contacted him, and he offered me multiple choices of what he could do, you know, from refunding, sending me a different copy, or including some extra comics in the next batch. So the seller is amazing, so we probably won't crack open any of these books, but for the other package we're going to crack some open because there were certain issues with them. Okay, I just want to make sure all the books are here. And what I've done is, and this is basically, let me read you the listing for this. Basically, he listed it, huge lot of 42 Wonder Woman New 52 DC Comics books, number 1 to 40, sharp unread copies. And whenever he says that, they're basically sharp unread copies. Okay, and this thing cost me, here, let me, what I did for this is actually, because if you, the first comic book haul video I ever made was the stuff that I bought. I bought some Valiants and I bought some Daredevils and stuff like this. And one thing I do when I'm buying comic books, I look at the unit cost of the books that I'm buying. And I sort of put together a little spreadsheet for this as well. I'll clean this up. I'll probably post it when I end up editing this video, the same way we did with that previous comic haul video, the first one that I put out with the Daredevils and the Valiant comics and some of the horror comics and stuff like this, right? So basically, these 42 comics, the New 52 Wonder Woman, they cost me $36, right? And that ended up being like 86 cents each. The shipping was $12.50. So the total cost, including shipping, of these guys was $48.50, and that includes 42 books. So basically, unit cost for this was $1.15 each. Okay, and for those of you who are collectors, the first issue of this is a second print, which I'm okay with. At some point, I might look for the first print of this, but I just really wanted to read Brian Azzarello's Wonder Woman. I haven't read it, and I've read some Wonder Woman. We put together a video. There was a request to do for the comic book reads. We put together a video for Wonder Woman 200, the original series, right? So we did that read and I really enjoyed it. And I've never really, I've read Wonder Woman. I've read some single issues and, you know, three run, two run, four run sets, story arcs and stuff like this. And definitely I've read Wonder Woman in Justice League and different comic books and stuff like this where they cross over. But I've never really read a full run of Wonder Woman. And I'm really looking forward to reading this, right? I really wanted to get my hands on this as soon as I found out that Brian Azzarello had done a Wonder Woman series, right? So let me pull this out. Then I crack this open with my Bloodshot box cutter, right? So let's take this out. And it's like, it's nicely wrapped up. Right? There's certain, and it's got extra bubble in the bottom. And there are certain sellers, if you come across and you're really happy with their product, you know, you probably do this already if you're buying online and stuff like this. You basically end up buying, you know, a lot from them. And he includes a little receipt of this stuff, right? So there's that bubble wrap. And he's packaged them up so they're nice and tight, so they don't fly around everywhere. Now, let's crack this guy open. And that's all it takes, right? You read one comic book that you really like, and I really like Wonder Woman 200. Someone posting a comment, they mentioned that was the I Ching era of Wonder Woman that some people had certain issues with because Wonder Woman lost his power, her powers and stuff like this. But I enjoyed it. I actually went back and picked up some of the other on eBay. I've done some other buys since reading number 200, and I've bought some of the other runs in the I Ching one. Once I get a complete run, I might do a marathon read on it. But choop, nicely slips out. And I love it where they separate it into, you know, like this. And there's number one. Sweet. Brian Azzarello and Cliff Chiang. Okay. So this is number one. And this is the second print. You're getting reflections off the light setup here. Right. That's number one. There's number three, four. Where's number two? Number zero. Let me see. Hopefully number two is in here. Let's see. Yeah, the comics should be 1 to 12, 0, 13 to 23, and then 23.1, 23.2, and those are the, I believe those are the 3D vernacular covers or whatever they call them. And then 24 to 36, it's missing number 37, 38, 39, and 40. Okay. So, let's take a look. That was number one. Oh, there's number two. Number two was right behind it. There's number two. I checked out some of the covers on these, and they looked beautiful. Look at this. Gods draw blood. She's in a pool of blood. I don't know who the character is behind her. Okay. So there's number 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This cover is fantastic. Number 8. She's like beautiful action. It's like John Woo. I think that's the director. For sure, most Wonder Woman runs, they have some kind of chains tied up, you know, bondage, if you want to think about it that way. Covers. Number 10, beautiful. There's that same girl from number 2, I guess. This one. Kiss of Death. Classic Wonder Woman jumping out. Beautiful. 13, 14, 15, 16. Ooh, look at this one. The cover of 16. Scary. She's been crawled over by flies. Seventeen, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. Beautiful. Cheetah. 24. Oh, okay, so these aren't the 3D ones. I have the 3D ones, so that's okay. These are the regular ones. 32.1 and 23.1 and 23.2. And these are the... what do you call it? The evil guys took over. And check this out. The covers between number 23.1 and 23.2. Wonder Woman is in the background, the same pose, right? Tied up. This was Cheetah, and then this is tied up with that guy. There she is again. And then let's check this out. 24, 25, 26. 27, that's a beautiful cover. Yeah. 28, 29, 30, 31. Here's another one tied up to a tree. Wonder Woman, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35. There's two 35s. There's one. I wonder why there's two 35s. Don't know. Monsters of the Month. Variant cover. So included another cover of 35, which is pretty sweet. Thank you very much. The variant cover, and this is so Brian Azzarello, 35 looks like it's the last issue he wrote, right? There's Brian Azzarello, his name up there, right? Is it the same artist again? Chiang Wilson. So 35, I'm not sure if Azzarello did anything past this, because with 36 is Finch. So hopefully I have the full Brian Azzarello run. And then it's missing 37. There's 38. Who's Wonder Woman getting married to? The Amazon startles the world in I Married a Monster. Look at the Flash. Flash is zooming around and he's saying, love is blind. Oh my God, he's all over the place. This is a beautiful cover. 39. And there, these things are mint copies. Or near mint, I guess. And there's number 40. Right. So fantastic. This one, we can put in a box until we're ready to do a read on the whole thing. Right. And I can go back and leave the comments. For the guy, for the seller, right? Let me set these up so they're not messing things up. Now, let me show you the next lot that I bought, and they're all Valiants, okay? Basically, I ended up buying, and I did a little, you know, again, the spreadsheet here. So I ended up buying 84 Valiants, okay, and they include Bloodshot, Ra, Unity, 4001, Exo, Ninjak, and Ivar. I bought 84 Valiants, not including shipping, for $84, so a dollar a pop. The shipping for this ended up costing a lot. Initially, the guy, let me lift this up. It's pretty heavy. I don't know why he shipped it out in this kind of box. Usually I get them in a, like a square box, so that might be cheaper. Initially, like look at this thing. Right. Initially, he sent it up prior to that. Initially, when I contacted him, he had a whole bunch of Valiants listed. When I contacted the seller, I asked him how much shipping would be if I bought multiple, you know, comics. And this was all bidding. It wasn't buy it now. And he quoted me. He said he could ship out a lot of them for like $18 or something like this, right? And the comic lots, I'll show you. Let me tell you what I ended up buying because I'm not sure if they're ordered or not. So some of these, well, they went for an amazing price. I bought, there was how many lots? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There were 7 auctions that I bought, that I won. There's a couple more that I was hoping to get, but I didn't get. The guy, when he listed them, he only gave like 2 seconds between the auctions finishing. So there was one lot that I really wanted to get. It had a, it was a Legends of a Geomancer lot. And man, if I could go back, I sent an email saying if he had another lot like that, I would pay, you know, 50% above what it sold for. And it sold for $50. And it had Legends of the Geomancer number 1, graded CGC for 9.8. Okay, so one of those, it had 3 or 4 Legends of the Geomancer number 2, 2 or 3 of number 3 and number 4, right? Like, it was a mega Legends of the Geomancer pack, and it went for $50. One person last minute outbid me, right? And I didn't get a chance to go on. I was bidding on some of the other ones, unfortunately. But this is what I ended up getting, right? I got Exo Man of War, right? 16 books, and they're 1 in 10 and 120 covers from number, it's got the annual, it's got the anniversary, number 13, number 36, number 36 to number 48. Most of them are the 1 in 20 variants. And there's a couple here that are 1 in 10. And I bought those for, they cost me $25, $24.50 basically, for 16 Exo Man of War books. I bought a Ninjak lot, 31 of them, right? From number 3 all the way up to number 18. And they're, I think they're the full runs of all the covers. They're the regular covers, the 1 in 10 covers, and 1 in 20 covers. And I bought those for $28.89. Okay. I bought Ivar, number 5 to number 12. And majority of them, there were some regular covers, some 1 in 10. But the majority of them are 1 in 20 variants. And I bought those, there's how many? 1, 2, 3. Actually, I listed them on the spreadsheet. How many is there? The Ivar, they're 14 books, and I bought them for $16.50. Okay. The Unity was, the Unity lot was 5 books for the Unity, that was being sold. 3 of them were 1 in 20 covers, and I bought those for 99 cents. 4001, Rye. The crossover that they did, number 13 to number 16, majority of them are the 1 in 20 cover, and I bought those for, how many is there actually, right, there's 10 of them, and I bought them for $2.25, and then there's a Bloodshot 7 book lot, and I bought those for $9.50, and they're majority 1 in 20. And then there's a 4001 single issue, which was a 1 in 20. So let's crack this open. And let me show you what they're, what's in here. Okay, let's bring this up. Heavy, heavy. I'm not sure if you can hear it, but someone's cutting the grass outside. Hopefully the noise is not bothering you guys. see how he's packaged them up. Oh wow, they're individually boxed. So check this out. He's put them in and he's got little boxes for each one individual, right? Schultz is just which one is this? Oh my god, that's cool. I don't know what the I don't have my computer set up, right? So I don't know which covers these are. Ah, look at this. So beautifully packaged. The guy was really nice, actually, when I was emailing him. The reason I was worried about this, because he quoted me $15 or $18. So it doesn't look like they're ordered. Everything's random. So I'll have to go through. So he quoted me $18 for as many of the boxes I was going to buy. But when it comes, this is the Ivar number 7. I don't know what variant this is. He quoted me $18. And then when it came time to shipping them, initially the stuff sat there, like he wasn't giving me the total. Bloodshot number 13, XO, like these are randoms. This is XO number 38. So when I bought them, everything was just sitting in the queue and he wasn't sending me the total. So you know, I asked him, you know, can you please send me the total so I can pay for it all, right? And Unity number 24. And he, you know, sent me a weird message saying, oh, you just have to go to eBay checkout and do it. And he was doing the stuff through eBay priority shipping. And though that's a scam, eBay charges way too much. And I usually don't buy from people that do eBay priority shipping. That's why I sent the message to the guy to get the quote. That's a cool cover. And I have all the Unity, I have all these Valiants, most of them anyway, but I don't have the variant covers. So the guy sort of said, you know, just go eBay checkout and pay for it. So I went there and, you know, if you bought off eBay, eBay tries to charge you shipping for all each one individually, right? And I said, listen, it's not letting me pay for it because it's charging me shipping for all of them individually, right? And he said, oh, he'll try to fix it. And, you know, a few days went by and no message. So I sent him a message. This is the 4001, the 1 in 20 cover. I know that one for sure. And this is the anniversary XO Matter War number 1. And then, you know, a few days went by and he contacted me saying, oh, eBay's not allowing him to do combined shipping. Which is weird because I've had other people do it. And he said he was going to check into it. And, you know, a few days went by and I sent him another message. And he said, oh, eBay wasn't allowing him to do it. And they looked into the shipping and it was going to cost $75 for shipping. And I went, wait a second, you quoted me 18. Now you're telling me it's going to cost me 75. That's huge. And then, it's number 13. And then he turned around and he sent me a message saying, oh, the person that's taking care of his shipping is not, doesn't really know what he's doing, his employee. So he's going to check into it himself. I was like, okay. So a few days went by and here's another one, right? I love these packages. Sweet Ivar. So I'll have to check these against the list because they're not in order. So yeah, they're not in order. It's just you just throw all the Valiants together in boxes and ship them out. So here's Ivar. So he said he was going to check into it. His employee was a dingling, I guess. That's what he was saying. He was saying, oh, he's not very smart and stuff. I was like, oof. Okay. So a few days went by and he didn't reply. And I sent him another email saying, listen, any chance of getting these books? I was really psyched to get these books. As you know, I'm a I love the Valiants. I love the Valiants. And this Rye, this is the Rye 4001. Oh, this is number 15. So this crossover, I love the 4001 series. The reflection is getting too much glare, but it's dark. And then he replied to me and said, he checked into it and his employee was correct. It was going to cost $70, right? I was like, whoa, $70 is too much. And then he said, I said I'm willing to pay, he quoted me 18 and I realized things can vary. I love these covers. These ones for Rye, beautiful. There's three or four of these. This is number 14. Absolutely beautiful. I'm going to put these up on the walls. I have all of them. And I said, you quoted me 18 and I realized everything's not set in stone, right? Sometimes things can cost more. I said, I'm willing to pay like 30, right? Almost, a lot more than what was quoted. And he said, listen, it's going to cost 70. And on the box here, it's actually the cost came out to 60. And I said, he said, if it's 70, if you're willing to split it, he'll ship it out to me. So it cost me $35 in shipping for these. Okay. This issue was amazing. Rye number 13. This Rye was absolutely beautiful. Now, this is sort of Rye 4001, sort of went through the story arc of the different Ryes throughout history. I really liked this kid as Rye. It really blew me away. And it was, I don't want to give spoilers if you're reading this. Fantastic. One of the best reads I had in 2016. So I said, sure, I'll pay $35 for shipping. So basically, there should be 84 books here. And without shipping, it cost me $1 a pop. With the $35 shipping, it cost me $1.42 each. Okay, which is a good price. They're $3.99, and these are all the variants. They're most of the variants for this run, for the books that I got. I think all the variants are included for each issue, most of the issues anyway, right? So it cost me $1.42 for the Valiants per unit. The Wonder Woman cost me $1.15 per unit. So these two buys together was 120 bucks. And if I don't include shipping, it cost me 95 cents per issue. If you include shipping, the 120 bucks, it was $1.33 per unit. Okay, which is a good price, which is a very good price as far as I'm concerned. Okay, here's the other Rye. That's number 14. And these are near mint. Mint near mint. Here's another cover. Sorry about the glare. Here's the Rye. Bloodshots. Nice. I like this cover. The Analog Man. This is number 11. Jeff Lemire, like seriously, what an amazing run this Bloodshot Reborn was. It's finished now, it kicked into Bloodshot USA, but what an amazing run. What an amazing run. One of the best reads of 2016. Wow, wow, wow. Well, I guess it started off in 2015, but wow, wow, wow. Here's number 17. I love the way this guy packaged them up. I'm definitely going to leave them positive feedback, even though, the shipping cost me a lot more than I was expecting. The only thing I feel I wish I'd won was the Geomancer lot, and we did the reads for Legends of the Geomancer 1-4, right? Ninjak, so happy to get my hands on all the Ninjak variants. This is number 10 again too. I don't know. I don't know which which ones these are. Look at this cover, beautiful. Operation Dead Side. Oh, I haven't read this this arc where they go to Dead Side, and I believe Shadow Man comes into play here. I haven't read these. I'm looking forward to reading these. Number 12. I did collect them. I just didn't get a chance to read them. And here's Rai again. Rai 13. Ninjak number 18. Right. Let me do a little adjustment here, because actually let me finish off these ones too. Ninjak number 18 again. Eternal Warrior. Ninjak number 17. Beautiful cover, eh? Look at this. Beautiful. That's Roku. Right. Beautiful cover. Noisy outside today. Here's number 16, Roku again. Beautiful covers, beautiful covers. Number 15, Matt Kinnett. Kindit is a writer. People are loving this series. I'm staying up with it now since reading the Silent issue. Like this, number 14. Sorry, I'm taking a little bit too long. I haven't seen these covers. Like, most stores aren't getting these variant covers. They're not ordering enough Valiants to get them. So I don't know what the print runs on these are. Right. I know some of the variants are going Operation Dead Side, number 12. Let me do a little adjustment. The stack is getting too big. Spread them out. Nice. And there's three more of these still. Bloodshot Reborn. Analog Man. Bloodshot Island was fantastic. Really, I really liked it. Wow, that's beautiful. This is CGC replica. Ty Walker Comics. This is so like 70s style. Not 70s, Golden Age style. Look at this cover. Beautiful. Right? So cool. Nice. Ivor. Look at this one. Number 5. Fantastic. This, I haven't read the Ivar. I read the first issue, I liked it, and I just fell behind. And from a lot of people, they consider Ivar Time Walker the series. And who's the writer for this? Oh yeah, Fred Van Lent. With Fred Van Lent stuff is amazing, right? People consider this to be amazing run, and I will read this at some point. I do have the full collection. But they're buried, so I might end up getting how many number fives? Look at this. There's like four different covers for number five, right? The regular 1 in 10, 1 in 20. I don't know what the other one would be. Let's see. Ivar Time Walker. There's four number fives. Ivar, where are you? So there's two regular covers, 5A, 1 in 10, and 120. Right. Awesome. Here's number 6. There's definitely a theme. Look at this one. But anyway, the people are considering this Ivar series to be absolutely amazing. And number 1 was fantastic. I just didn't get a chance to continue to read, stay up with it. Number 7. Looks like everything's here. Number 8. Or number 7. Number 7. Right. Ninjak number 3. Check this out. Awesome. Ninjak number 3 again. And these are beautiful copies. Very James Bondish. Ivar. Ninjak. Nice. Ninjak number 8. And take a look at this one. I think this is the first appearance of this character here. Right, this is the brother, I forget what the names are and stuff like this. I love this cover. I thought this cover was absolutely amazing. Same with Ninjak number 4 with Roku standing there with her hair, stuff like this. That was beautiful cover as well. But I love this cover. I actually bought a couple of 2 or 3 copies of this one when it first came out. That's, if I love a cover, if I love a series, sometimes you buy multiple copies. That's the same character that was biting Ninjak's neck. This guy too. They're the ones that are in the story arc right now with issue number 24 and 25 and stuff. They're going, I'm not 100% sure where they're going. Shadow 7, Deathless. Yeah, Shadow 7, check this out. Right, here's the names of them. Cool. Ninjak number 5. Ninjak number 5. Ninjak number 5. Take a look at the last one here. Nice. Beautifully packaged, really. I have bought stuff off eBay where the packaging wasn't the best. And there's one time where it was horrendous packaging when I actually bought Tick number 1 and I bought the Tick series. Not all of them, it was missing number 2. And it was all the way up to 10 or something like this, and the guy just threw in a box in a bag, like it was crazy. So I left a negative feedback and the guy was really upset and he apologized and he said he wasn't the regular shipper. There's a lot of excuses people give, that his wife was doing it. And then what he ended up doing, he refunded me the whole payment for that package. So if you end up getting a bad shipment, you know, someone is not up to snuff. What? Whoop, don't fall now. That's what this guy did. Definitely contact the seller. But I ended up, it was horrendous. I was pretty upset about it, I guess. So I left a negative feedback without contacting the guy. And the guy apologized and refunded the whole funds. And he said, listen, can you please call eBay? Because his wife would be really pissed to get negative feedback. Can you get that negative feedback removed? And I did. I called eBay and they put me on hold for like, it took me like half an hour, right? But the guy was really nice. So I ended up explaining to eBay that, you know, he refunded and was quick on the trigger. And, you know, if they could remove his negative feedback. And after about half an hour talking and he jumped from one person to another, they agreed. And he was really happy. And I was, you know, I was happy to do that, right? And that's the only negative feedback I ever left. I've got some other stuff where the books that I got weren't exactly as they explained and stuff. And I just don't buy from those sellers again, right? But most of the stuff that I get, I'm very happy with. Number 36. Number 44. Some of these variants I really wanted to get my hands on when they were coming out, but they're hard to get your hands on, right? Really, they're hard to get your hands on them. Some of them, not this time, right? Nice lots. Number 46. Nice. Number 45. And Ninjak number 9. Sweet. Sweet. I didn't count. I will go through and check them all against the lots, make sure they're all there. But I'm definitely going to go and leave a positive feedback for them as soon as I do all the checking and put them in a short box and see what we'll end up reading, right? I thought I'd share this with you. I was really happy to get these. I thought you'd enjoy as well. I'm definitely going to read Brian Azzarello's Wonder Woman. Okay. That's it for now. This is one of the things I'm doing in my Bill Hicks break. People were like a little bit concerned, worried that, you know, something might be up. Nothing's up. Just taking a break. Every now and then you just need a break, right? And it's really nice getting a package like this on a break, right? Fantastic. That's it for now. I'll see you guys in the next video.